Kristen, about 120 boats have entered. Many of them you can see here right behind me having a little bit of a party. Boats have been coming in throughout the day, and tomorrow they'll be leaving the dock here in Boyne City, heading to Charlevoix, Elk Rapids, Harbor Springs, Bay Harbor, then ends at Horton Bay. Each stop, boaters will get a card, and whoever has the best hand at the end wins. The Poker Run raises money for Camp Quality, a summer camp for children with cancer, and Challenge Mountain, a group that puts on outdoor activities for mentally and physically challenged children. But this is the biggest event they've had so far, and last year they raised about $130,000 for charity. Reporting live in Boyne City, Connor Hansen, 7 and 4 News.
Unreal Sensation, sponsors, Boyne Thunder Poker Run, enjoying some grub at Boyne Mountain. Sushi, cocktails.
You know, what it does for the city, it's absolutely incredible. They bring so much to the town. Everybody's there spending money, it boosts the economy, and it goes for such a great cause. And I believe it's around $700,000 that they've donated to Camp Quality over the last 10 or 12 years. It's incredible.
We have a great turnout this year. We have 120 boats, which was our limit this year. We anticipate that right now at this event, we have probably 50 to 60% of them already in the area because of the 4th of July and enjoying the area. Tomorrow, they all get access to their docks at noon. We release the docks from our seasonal boaters, and so we'll be able to take those over as the event grows. Tomorrow night, we'll put boats on the street. We've got a great street party planned. We have sponsors on one street, another, and we'll probably have somewhere in the 6 to 7, maybe 8,000 people that will kind of come into Boyne City. It's an event that has grown in size simply because there's no other event like it in northern Michigan.
But I don't know how fast I'm going to run. Depends how rough it is. I haven't had time to get to where I'm one with that boat yet. I just been too busy. The weather's been bad. So hopefully by the end of this weekend, well, I've had kids. I got 7 grandkids that have kids in it, you know. So time to cut loose.
Dungy from Saginaw, Michigan, run a 43-foot F4 Sensation. This is my 5th year up here.
People are great, great water, just a great time.
Boyne Thunder is, everybody looks forward to it more than the 4th of July, I think. It's like Christmas for a lot of people.
Well, Well, Saturday looks like it's going to be another fun run. The winds are supposed to be a little bit calm, hopefully kicking up a little bit in the afternoon. But for all the boats, I think we're going to have a good run out here. This is probably my sixth or seventh participation in the Boyne Thunder, and it's a highlight of my summer every year. Looking forward to it.
And the people that put it on, amazing, you know. But the water, the surrounding area, it's just unbelievable, you know. So you plan it a year in advance, there's no excuse for missing it, right? So that's what we've been doing.
Everybody has their 4th of July parades and all sorts of other events, but they don't have a Boyne Thunder, and it's really been tremendous. On Saturday morning, we'll have our driver's meeting, and around 9:45, 10 o'clock in that area, we will release the boats from the marina, and we divide them up into four groups, and they will proceed out through down Lake Charlevoix, out through Round Lake, and out into Lake Michigan, and that's where all the fun begins. We get out there, and it's about 140 mile course altogether, and 140, maybe 145. That with a reception back at Somerset about 3:30 to 4:30 in the afternoon after all the boats have made that run and had a lunch stop, and we conclude the evening with a dinner and then a display of the cards and an auction and all of that. We've raised last year our amount was around $178,000 we raised on the weekend. We look to that to be up just a little bit this year because we do have a few more boats and a few more participants, and you know, Lord help us with all of our sponsors that we have, and the beneficiaries benefit from that, and the work that our sponsors, or at least the donations that our sponsors provide us.
To me, Boyne Thunder is just the perfect example of community coming together. People from all over the U.S. and all over the state gathering together in Boyne City to make our community what it is. And just the impact and the excitement and everything that goes with it is what people love about Boyne and what I love about Boyne.
Challenge Mountain provides adaptive recreation for individuals living with disabilities and their families. We provide year-round recreational opportunities in all seasons, including skiing, snowboarding, snowshoeing. In the spring and fall, we do adaptive biking, kayaking, boating in the summer, equine therapy, and ropes challenge course. All of our programs are provided free of charge to individuals and their families, and they're all provided by volunteers. So Boyne Thunder is one of our biggest fundraisers, and it's so important in our efforts and our mission to continue to connect individuals with life-enhancing experiences, because we believe that every individual should have the opportunity to experience life and adventure. And at Challenge Mountain, we make these great opportunities happen together with our volunteers, a very small staff, and all of the wonderful individuals and families that come to us to play and enrich their lives.
My name is Kristen Balog. I'm the executive director for Camp Quality. We are an organization that sets up camp for kids with cancer. We set up a healthcare station so these children have an opportunity to come to camp. We provide treatment on site thanks to hundreds of volunteers, including volunteer doctors and nurses who can tend to the medical needs of these children.
So every participant here in Boyne Thunder is making such a difference.
We have 125 boats here today, and each one of those boats is contributing to the opportunity of a child to have a normal summer camp experience.
All the individuals living with disabilities, children and adults, and their families come to Challenge Mountain to experience life and adventure. And everyone here at Boyne Thunder, with your participation, makes those opportunities available to more individuals each year. So from all of the volunteers and all of those that we serve here at Challenge Mountain, we thank you for coming to Boyne City, for participating in our community, and for giving back to Challenge Mountain and all those we serve. Thank you.
So these boaters don't realize what they're providing, memories of a lifetime. They're providing hope and inspiration. They're providing support to children and families who are going through a journey with cancer that we might not be able to relate to, but they are providing an experience of summer camp that these kids could not have without their funds. So we have four of our camper families here today, and they're out on a powerboat ride. Usually taking off from the dock, they're a little nervous, they're unsure of what to expect. How fast is this boat gonna go? Well, I can tell you, this boat will be taking them 55 miles an hour up Lake Charlevoix, and it is an experience of a lifetime. When they come back in, their usual reaction is, can we go again? And that in and of itself is one of the many thrills that these kids get to have that we are providing here at Boyne Thunder, thanks to the hundreds of boaters that we have in the docks here today in Boyne City.
Garrett is 17, about to be 17 here in this week. And he's gone through two battles with cancer, one at 6 years old and one at 15. The first one was medulloblastoma, and they did full radiation, and this cancer this last time around was from the radiation, from the original time you did it.
I've never been on a fast, really fast boat like this, and they look really cool. It's going to be fun seeing how fast they're really going to go, and sometimes it's nice just feeling the wind brush against your face.
How do you really describe people that donate their time like that? And money that
to give us a ride, spending money on the boats, and it just brings a lot of kids, a lot of happiness. It's really exciting, and I just want to thank basically everybody.
Here at Boyne Thunder, and this is our new boat. It's a 42X cigarette. It's an 06, just been completely redone. We enjoy coming up here, enjoy the cigarette. Great water up here.
The people are all great here. It's nice, the camaraderie between the boat racers and stuff. It's just a great crew. Great crew.
All right, this is the first boat for Stereo Wars.
All right.
We're gonna give you a 3-2-1 countdown. You've got 90 seconds to show us what you've got. You ready? Here we go. In 3, 2, 1.
Oh, Someone's there.